We come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. What hinders the family and the neighborhood of Jesus to recognize Him and perhaps even to affirm and praise Him for the good things that He has done, healing of the sick, driving out demons, and proclaiming the good news? Why do they come to disown a member of their family because of the good things that He is doing in the name of our Lord and God? For the times that we are too judgmental with our brothers and sisters because they are rising in fame in the name of God, rejecting those who are doing the work of God, hear us ask for pardon and for God's mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lead us, Lord God, to imitate constancy of Saint Eusebius in affirming the divinity of your Son, so that preserving the faith He taught us, your Bishop, we may share in the very life of your Son. O God, who adorned Saint Peter, John, and Amar with a wonderful love for the sacred mysteries of the body and blood of your Son, graciously grant we to may be worthy to receive the delights He drew from this divine banquet. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In the beginning of the reign of Eliakim, son of Josiah, king of Judah, this message came from the Lord. Thus says the Lord, stand in the court of the house of the Lord, and speak to the people of all the cities, who come to worship in the house of the Lord. Whatever I command you, tell them, and omit nothing. Perhaps they will be sent after him back, each from his evil way, so that I may repent of the evil I have planned to inflict upon them for their evil deeds. Say to them, thus says the Lord, if you disobey me, not living according to the law I place before you, and not listening to the words of my servants, the prophets, whom I send you constantly, though you do not obey them, I will treat this house like Shemo, and make this a city to which all the nations of the earth shall refer and curse another. Now the priests, the prophets, and all the people heard Jeremiah speak these words in the house of the Lord. When Jeremiah finished speaking all that the Lord bade him speak to all the people, the priests and prophets laid hold of him, crying, you must be put to death. Why do you prophesy in the name of the Lord? This house shall be like Shiloh, and this the city shall be desolate and deserted. And all the people gathered about Jeremiah in the in the house of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Those outnumber the hairs of my head, who aid me without cause. Too many for my sin, are they who wrongfully are my enemies. Messiahs for what I did not steal.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Since for your sake I bear insult, and shame covers my face, I have become an outcast to my brothers, a stranger to my mother's sons, because you, for your house, conscience me, and the insults of those who blaspheme you fall upon me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
But I pray to you, O Lord, for the time of your favor, O God, in your great kindness, answer me with your constant help.
Lord, in your great love, answer me. Please stand to honor the gospel.
This is the word that has been proclaimed to you. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to his native place and taught the people in their synagogue. They were astonished and said, "Where did this man get such wisdom and might? Is he not the carpenter's son? Is he not his mother named Mary and his brothers James, Joseph, Simon, and Judah? Are not his sisters all with us? Where did this man get all this?" And they took offense at him. But Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor except in his native place and in his own house. And he did not work many mighty deeds there because of their lack of." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Commonly, when we are being corrected by people who are knowledgeable of the wisdom of God, yung ating reaction ay to reject the person. And pag na-reject ko din bawa tayo, na-reject tayo ng kapwa-tao, then alam natin na ang sinasabi natin ay katotohanan. Alam natin na ang sinasabi natin ay para sa kabutihan ng lahat. At pawang ito ay nakakatulong sa ating paglago, sa ating pananampalataya. Yan, tayo rin ay para bang mawalan rin ng lakas. And more often than not, surrender tayo. So when we do that, pag ganun ang nangyayari, na hindi naman natin maiwasan ang pagka-judgmental ng maraming mga tao dahil sa kanilang, sabihin natin, kayamangan. Sana tayo na nanindigan sa katotohanan, nagsasabi ng pamahayag ng katotohanan ng pag-ibig at awa ng Diyos, na ang Diyos ay kumikiling doon sa kinikilingan niya yung mga mahihirap, yung mga walang lakas, mahihina, and that would somehow give us the strength the courage to go out on our mission, the mission of Jesus, to proclaim the kingdom of God. But more often than not, ay tayo rin. Kung ganun man lang, ay kayo lang dyan, without giving that and that, but deep down in your heart, yung ano mo, pagtangpo ka na lang. And yung pagtangpo mo, ay napabayaan mo na rin ang iyong tungkulin. Para pagka nagtangpo ka sa tao, pero pinaligdan mo na rin ang Diyos. What our readings for today, ang binibigay niya sa ating na leksyon, kahit sa ating unang pagbasa, si propeta, ang propeta, si Jeremias, at lahat ng mga propeta ay nakadanas nito. Dahil sinasabi nila lahat yung sinasabi, inutos ng Diyos sa kanila na kanilang sasabihin doon sa mga tao na sa kalawakan, doon sa mga nagkakibagan ng Diyos na nila sa kanilang kalooban at kalimutan nila ang kalooban ng Diyos, ay nagkaroon ng karanasan ng rejection. Nagkaroon sila ng karanasan ng discrimination, nagkaranasan ng judgment, condemnation, no, ng kapwa-tao. Kung ikaw ay gumagawa ng mabuti, nagsasabi ng buong katotohanan at kabutihan dahil ginagampanan mo ang papel mo sa buhay dito sa mundo na iyong pinapahayag ang kabutihan, kagandahang loob ng Diyos, ang awa ng Diyos. But if you mean sometimes that ganun-ganun mga pangyayari, then parang tama na. Mahirap na, napagod na ako. Why? Bakit naduwalan din sa atin yung napapagod tayo? Yan ang tinatawag natin na mission fatigue natin. Parang kapagod sa mission. It is because we are unable to replenish yung kailangan natin na strength, lakas, at courage, tibay ng kalooban. And we could only give that kapag tayo ay masinsinan, paglaki, na mayroon tayong discipline sa buhay, at ang discipline sa buhay ay mangyari lamang kapag tayo ay matalik na kaibigan ni Kristo. If we make our prayer morning and especially morning and evening prayer, it is in there that we are able to listen attentively at kung anong marinig natin sa salita ng Diyos, ayanin natin na makarating sa ating puso. Upang nang sa ganon, ay magkaroon tayo ng iba yung lakas, iba yung tibay ng kalooban. We will have the courage and the strength to face every adversity that comes in our life. Never, never give up. If we are proclaiming the word of God, if we come to witness the word of Jesus, that is truly God, and come to embrace our humanity, that's coming to be true man as well, then lead us continue. Ito ngayon ang naging karanasan ni Jesus. Nang siya gumalik doon sa kanila, sa Nazareth, Aba, hindi makatanggap-tanggap ng taga-Nazareth na ito kanilang kababayan. Ito kanilang relative, yung kamag-anak. Iba na, mataas na ang kanyang mga sinasabi at hindi malayo sa kanilang karanasan ng katotohanan ng sinasabi niya ay pawang katotohanan. Dahil narinig na rin nilang balita na si Jesus ay nagpapagaling ng mga may sakit, nagtataboy ng mga demonyo. But yet, anong isinabi sa ating husband? dictate or make offense on him. Sinaktan pa nila ang damdamin. Nag-dinuli pa nila. Aba, manginig kayo dyan. Bakit manginig kayo dyan? Taka dito lang pa dyan. Kilala natin yan. Di ba dito yung mga kapatid yan, mga kapulad yan? Yan yung ordinary. Eh, mas ano pala tayo? Mas akat pang ating buhay kaysa kanila. Kasi sila yung mga mahihirap. Carpenter lang yan ang bakay. Ang nanay na sa bakay ng mga. See how judgmental people are. And in that way, kapag ganun ang uri ng mga tao, sino ang kanilang pinaatake? Sino ang kanilang binubuli? Hindi lang yung tao na pinadala ng Diyos, kundi mismo ang Diyos. We pray again. Lahat-lahat tayo ng reverently and anti na mapagpagalangin natin na sana hindi tayo maging katulad ng mga mayayabang na mga naapintuhan ng paghahari ng demonyo. Lead us, go still. Sundan pa rin natin si Jesus despite all yung pambuhuli sa Kanya, yung judgmental ng mga sinasabi sa Kanya, kahit na siya ay nireject, sinaktan, tuloy pa rin. Tuloy pa rin dahil ang paniniwala na hindi kailanman magpagi ang kasamaan at lagi mamayagpag at magpagi ang kabutihan na ayon sa planong kalooban ng Diyos. Siya naman. Jesus was rejected by his own people. In faith, we accept him as our Lord and Savior. For in prayer we say, Jesus, lead us, let our lives honor you.
Jesus, let our lives honor you. To the leaders of the church, please speak the word of the God with courage and with compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, let our lives honor you.
That we may be strengthened to proclaim joyously and earnestly the gospel message in our homes and neighborhood. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, let our lives honor you.
That missionaries may be patient and love closely in solving the message of God to unwelcoming places. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, let our lives honor you.
That parents of handicapped children, those who care for the aged, and all those who are suffering at home or in the hospital, may hear silent witness to the love of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, let our lives honor you.
That God may comfort those who are mourning over the death of their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, let our lives honor you.
In silence, let us offer our personal intention.
Let us pray especially for peace and justice, especially amongst our family, Filipino families, victims of the extrajudicial killing and all other atrocities and injustices, especially through corruption of government funds, that the Lord will touch the heart of our leaders and be converted to Jesus Christ. We pray.
Jesus, let our lives honor you.
Heavenly Father, we call on you with confidence to hear the prayers of your people. Let us ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you. the present oblation, O Lord, with which we offer in commemoration of Blessed Eusebius and Holy and Imart, Peter, Holy and Imart, bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is really right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits, you crown your own gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. And by their intercession, your support, so that in courage, by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory. Through Christ our Lord, and so with the angels and archangels, with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Listen. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray the partaking of the body of God of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Pablo, Virgilio, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, especially souls in the purgatory. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints of peace, you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
By the Savior's command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that through the help of your mercy, we always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Let us go to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us all safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you.
enables them.
Blessed are the clean of heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. Let us pray. Nourished by these sacred gifts, we humbly implore you, Lord, that the homage of dutiful service which we render on the feast day of Blessed Eusebius and Peter Nehemiah may bring us an increase of your saving grace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Each day for the prayer to Our Lady of Grace. Dearest Mother, Our Lady of Grace, by the power of the Holy Spirit, your faithfulness to the will of the Father brought us Jesus the Savior as the Father's greatest gift of all. With the confidence of a trusting child, I place in your loving hands the prayers of the whole Church. I also entrust to you, Mother of Grace, this urgent need of your child. Loving Mother, Our Lady of Grace, like you, I open myself and my life to the wisdom and mercy of our Father. May the Father's will be done in you and in all those I place in your care. With you, O Mother of Grace, I pray this to the Father, in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You shall stand.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong pag-ipag-isa sa ating kapiliwang sa misa sa hapong ito. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be
Thanks
to God.
Thanks be to God.
At nakapag po,
subscribe my YouTube channel, Captain BB. Thank you and God bless.